Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2084, Sort Worksheet Tabs Alphabetically. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question from Pam. Is there a way to alphabetize the worksheet tabs? Well, there's no built-in way to do that, but we could do it with a macro. And now, this is a macro that really should be in the Personal Macro Workbook. All right, so if you've never done macros before, we're going to do Alt-T for Tom, M for Mary, S for Sam, and make sure to move from Disable All Macros Without Notification to Disable All Macros With Notification. All right, then press Alt F8 and take a look and see if you have any macros. Make sure to choose Macros in All Open Workbooks. If you don't have anything that starts as personal.xlsb, you need to do these optional steps. If you already have something with personal.xlsb, then just hold on for a second. All right, so we're going to go out to the View tab and we're going to record a new macro. It's going to be called Hello World, no space, no space. And we're going to store the macro in the Personal Macro Workbook. Click OK and just type somewhere Hello World like that, and then come down here next to Ready and click Stop. All right, now that will force you to have a Personal Macro Workbook. All right, if you've never used macros before, you may not have that. At this point, we're going to press Alt F11. And if you've never used macros, you're going to get this gray screen here. We're going to go to View, Project Explorer, and we're going to find the new personal.xlsb. If you already have a module there, which of course you will, sure, yeah. Open Modules and double-click Module 1. Now, I already have a couple of macros in my Personal Macro Workbook, but I'm going to come right down here to the last row, put a couple spaces in. All right, so then you would type this code that I pasted in. We're going to talk about this macro as I run it, so I'm going to run it one line at a time by pressing the F8 key. And one thing I learned here is after finishing this sort, it was a little bit disconcerting to end up on a different sheet, so I remembered what sheet we're on, so later on I can select it right before the macro is done. Okay, now here we are. Let's go back to Excel, and you'll see that the first sheet there is called Title. We're currently on a sheet called Question. I want to add a new sheet before Title. So we do worksheets.add, and then I want to rename that. Currently comes in as Sheet 1 as Temp Sort Sheet. Be careful, this should be a name that you would never happen to use. Like, don't call this Income Statement, right? Just use something very random, so that way you'll run into an error if you already have a sheet called Temp Sort Sheet. And then what I found is that I was using this worksheets.count over and over and over again, so I'm just going to put it in a variable. It's easier to say WSC than worksheets.count later on. So we have 150 worksheets, and we're going to list those worksheets. All right, so here on the first time through the loop, we're going to go from 1 to 150. On the first time through the loop, to our brand new sheet that we added, the temp sort sheet, on row 1, column 1, we're going to put a value that's equal to the first worksheet. All right, and what that should be is, well, yep, temp sort sheet right there. But I'm going to let this run a couple more times. I'll press F8. And you'll see that we're getting all of the sheet tabs in the order that they're appearing in the workbook. And pretty soon I start to get to those tabs that have the account numbers, right? And I'm going to let this run. I don't want to have to press F8 300 times. So I'm going to click here and go to Debug, Run to Cursor, which is Control F8. Which will finish that out. You see we have a list of all 150 sheet tabs. That's awesome. And now here's where we take advantage of the power of Excel. There's a lot of postings online, including at the Mr. Excel message board, where they actually try and sort, they write their own sort to move the sheets around. And we're going to take advantage of Excel here, because Excel has a sort. And I'm using the code from Excel 2003. I like this code, easier to remember. I'm going to start in A1, resize it to be 150 cells. We're going to sort that. The key is going to be A1. Well, that's the only thing it could be. Order is going to be ascending. And make sure to specify that there is a header, right? We don't want our temp sort sheet to sort down into the data. All right, so right there, bam, that does the sort. Yeah, we don't need to write our own bubble sort code. And then we're going to go from row 2, which is A120. The sheet to move is A120. Why the quote quote? In case you have a sheet name like we had earlier this week, like a sheet name 123, that would confuse Excel. And then where we're going to move it to? We're going to move it to not row 2, but after the first sheet. So move after becomes 1. So we're going to take our sheet called A120 and move it after the first sheet like that, F8. And there it worked. those three lines one more time, A124 comes to the right spot. At this point now we know it's working. We can do Control F8, which does all of the moving. 150 moves just happened there. And now I'm going to delete the original sheet, that is, or delete the temp sort sheet. But before I delete it, I don't want them to tell whoever's running the code that we're about to delete the sheet. So I just delete it and then select the original sheet and display a message that the workbooks have been sorted like that. Okay, so now that we have the macro, we know the macro is working and it's in the personal macro workbook. A couple things we want to do. Alt F11, come back here and make sure that you're in the personal macro workbook. Click there and click save. If you don't save it now, later on when you're closing Excel, it's going to flash up this message about, do you want to save changes to personal.xlsb, and you'll completely forget and not save the changes, right? So I always make sure to save the changes. And then Alt Tab, we're going to customize the quick access toolbar. Choose from macros, find the one that's called sort sheets, add that to the quick access toolbar. I don't like the flowchart, so we'll look for something that says A to Z, or you know, something here. Let's use this one and put a little tab there of sort sheets like that. Click OK. Click OK. All right, now here's the test. I'll insert a new workbook. I'll make some copies of the sheets. And we'll put them in kind of a weird sequence, Z and then Y and then M and then B, like that. Click sort sheets and bam, they're back in the right sequence. How cool is that? All right, so today's episode, Pam wants to sort the worksheet tabs alphabetically. Well, we used a macro, first change the macro security. Record a Hello World macro into the personal macro workbook, and then type the code in the personal macro workbook and assign that to a quick access toolbar button. I want to thank Pam for that question, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.